Thank you for coming in today. I really appreciate you guys coming back. I'm Courtney Mills, and I'm a social worker here at Eaglesville Counseling Services. Last week, we met for the first time, and we discussed kind of what was going on within the family. So, if you don't mind, I would like to go around and kind of say your name and just what's going on in your perspective. We'll start with you.
I'm Emily, and these are my two daughters. And we're here because just recently my husband left, and some of us aren't taking it well. I just don't know what to do anymore. It was totally unexpected, and I'm pretty lost.
I'm Erica, and my dad left, and I feel really upset about the situation. I'm not sure what to do. It feels really awkward at home, and I just don't like to be there because it just doesn't feel right without him there.
I'm Jessica. I'm a college daughter. Our dad did leave, but honestly, I'm not really upset about the situation. Like, if he wanted to leave us and our family, then that's his choice. If he didn't love us enough to stick around, and that's his business, but it doesn't bother me.
Okay. Would you guys mind just telling me a bit about this past week? How was this past evening without your dad?
Well, without my husband, I've just been totally lost. I just don't really know what to do with myself. Anything that I do just doesn't feel right. I feel like a piece of me is just missing. I don't understand. There's no closure. I just really wish I knew what made all this happen, and I wish I could just go back and make it better.
Mm-hmm.
We just really don't feel like a family anymore. Like, he's not there, and he's supposed to be there. We don't feel like a family.
Well, I'm Erica, really upset about the situation, but I just think that if he didn't want to stick around, then he didn't want to stick around. I mean, I guess I'm more angry than I am upset. And so, I mean, this week, it has been tough not having him around, but I mean, I haven't been crying about it or anything. It just makes him mad.
Yeah. I know this is just a horrible situation, and I hate this really bad. Are there any strengths that you guys can see in the situation at all?
I think a strength for me is having both my girls to be here for support, and I feel like I can turn to them. But right now, like I said earlier, I'm just so lost. I just don't know what to do. I don't know where to go next. I don't know how to continue on with my life without him here. We've been together for so long, and then it just was just a sudden thing. Next day, he didn't come home from work and didn't call, and we haven't heard from him, and we don't know what happened. So, but like I said, a strength would definitely be that I have my girls to lean on, and I also have my work. The people at my work have really been understanding the situation, and they really tried to help me cope with everything, but they don't know what I'm going through, really, because they haven't been through what I've been through. But having them there,
I felt like our family is a strength. We depend on each other, like you said. But I feel like I can talk to my mom about it, and it can help me, you know, because we have similar feelings and stuff. So.
I guess the strength for us is that we still do have mom. A lot of kids don't even have parents at all. So it is a good thing for us that we do have a mom who does love and care about us and has to stick around and help us get through this.
This week, as I was looking through your case files, I created what's called an eco map. And what this is it's just kind of a chart to kind of tell, you know, what's going on in the family, what are some strengths in your family, and what are maybe some strains that are going on. So I kind of filled in a little bit about what I knew, which I, you know, we are just starting this, so I don't know a lot. But just like you said, another strength would be your family system. You have a good, supportive family system. This poor circle right here, it describes the relationship between you guys. This is Emily, just the mom. And then this represents your husband. And these are Erica and Jessica. And these circles that are drawn out here are kind of showing, like I said, the strengths and the negatives of what's going on. So, like last week, I know that you told me about church is kind of a safe haven for you, so you really rely on your church, and like you said, the day of your work. So that's another thing that we can add on here, is your work, and for each of you, we can add that you have a supportive family group. So I was just going to ask you, are there anything else, is there anything else that you guys can think of that I could add that may be a positive or even a negative with the situation that's going on right now?
For me, it'll be school. It is something to get my mind off the situation. I have friends there, I have teachers who know about the situation, and are there to ask me if I'm okay. So that's
a helpful situation for you?
Yeah, I feel like there's other people that are there.
Okay. So school is kind of something that helps you, and your teachers are really supportive as well.
Right.
Okay. That's a really good one. Thank you for sharing that with me. Is there any others that you guys can make?
I think other than church and work, and my girls, I would say that what you have on there is pretty much covers my support system.
Okay. And we'll be using this throughout the process if you guys can think of any more strengths that we can add. This kind of just helps us look at the positives and focus on what's going good in that situation. Okay, next I want to kind of ask you a question. It's called a miracle question. And that is just me saying, if you woke up tomorrow and this your husband would not have walked out, if your dad would not have walked out, what would your life look like right now? So would you like to start?
Sure. Definitely I would have my husband back. Our family would be complete. There would be no arguing. We would all stick together. And my husband would have never left. And we would learn to work out our issues, because there's obviously some kind of issue that he wasn't telling me about that he had with me or the girls. So maybe we could learn more ways to deal with our issues with one another so that we can work through things so that one of us doesn't have to leave.
I feel like if he came back, it would be a good thing. We would have our family back and we would all be happy. Move on with their lives, like everything would be perfect back to normal.
I do miss my dad, and I am mad at him. If he came back, I don't think I would be happy. I think I would always be mad at him for him leaving us. So I don't think that realistically that's like my perfect situation. To me, it was just important that my mom and my sister just accept what has happened and just find peace with the situation. And to me, that was just perfect. It's just us three just moving on and creating our own family, just do love each other and want to be a part of the family.
Okay. So if we could look at the situation before it happened, would you say that your life looked kind of like what you just said? Would you say that it looked the same?
I think my perfect picture looks the same as pretty much how our life was before he left, other than the whole communication issue and not communicating with each other when we do have an issue with one another. And I know that I had some things that I didn't enjoy about him or some things that I didn't agree with, but that wasn't a reason, that wouldn't ever be a reason for me to just up and leave and not give any explanation or not. So other than that, I think what was before would be the same as my perfect scenario.
I mean, I feel the same. I don't know, like, you could tell, like, things were kind of weird towards the end, I guess, maybe. They just weren't doing the long stuff, but I think that if he came back, that things would be better. Like, I think they would look up and be more positive.
So. Well, I didn't realize anything was even going on in the beginning, and I don't know if it's because nobody realized it or if it was because I was just so busy that I couldn't realize it, that anything was wrong. So that just
feel like our relationship would have been better if we would have had better communication skills.
I would say at 8, I really enjoyed spending time with my dad. I think he was an important person in my life. So, I really miss him. Like, I feel like he should be there, you know?
Until next week, and then when we come together, we'll all bring it back together and kind of all